It has been a very hectic tour. Non-stop presentations on all of the media, presentations on every venue around the nation. And from here we will be going to Dresden, Germany. From Germany we will be going to Paris. And from Paris we'll go to Holland. From Holland I will be going to Penang, Malaysia. From Penang, Malaysia we'll go to Kuala Lumpur. And then back to the United States for another tour in the United States. But I'm trying to cut as much as possible because it just means one thing after the other in terms of events. I want to be finished by December for the simple reason that I need to recover. It's been 6 years doing this nonstop, and it has taken an emotional toll because I never had the opportunity to grieve like everybody else. My grieving process has been basically in front of the media all this time, and it's really devastating. Also because I have my family, I'm a newlywed guy, and my wife can hardly find me because I'm always traveling, and she cannot travel with me at the same time. So it's been a huge amount of non-stop presentation. The thing is that when I started these presentations, it took a huge peak when it was announced that I was going to be on the television program The View with Rosie O'Donnell. And a lot of attacks happened one after the other. I started getting people attacking me on the internet because they didn't want this information to come out. There was a guy in New York that was writing an article, 103 pages article, trying to debunk me. And instead of actually destroying me, what he did, it incremented the level of requests all over the world to get presentations. And it was just like, it helped me immensely. So that's what we're doing right now.
So he became your publicist.
He became my publicist, and he don't even know it. So actually what I do now, every time I put my email, the email signature, I put his attack piece so people will read it. And it's funny because, you get all these forums trying to debunk you, and they forget that on every email that I send, I have a list of 65,000 people on my email list. And most of the chunk of the same group of people that I have is the victim families. So I will be very transparent with them. This is what they're saying, this is what my position is. So they turn a lot of the families off with what they're doing.
If I could just return back to the day.
Well, I don't want to relate the whole process, I just did it over there, but
no.
Basically...
I can explain my situation. I was involved in a stadium, a football stadium, where 100 supporters of Liverpool football club died in a
really? What year was that?
In 1989.
That was the thing, I think I remember something, that everybody tried to run and they stampeded everybody.
Exactly, see this is the...
Correct.
But it wasn't like that. That was the story released 5 minutes after it happened.
And that's what was sold to the world.
Yes. Now, for 17, 18 years, we've had this ongoing quest for justice. Because of those 5 minutes after it happened, and this happened with 150,000 people at a stadium, TV cameras, etc., and still the truth
did not come out.
But from my own personal experience in that, by a quirk of fate, I was a little bit late for the game, by 15, 20 minutes. So I didn't get killed because of that, and I was able to help other people. You had a very similar situation because you were late for work that day. How often do you think about that quirk of fate?
I think about what happened on 9/11 every single day. It's a non-stop emotional journey. A roller coaster of emotion that never ever stopped a single time. The worst part, like I explained before, is that I have been doing my grieving process in front of the world. I never have the privacy to do it like every other victim. I developed what they call survivor's guilt. Why did I survive and the other people didn't? Why am I here? And my friends did not make it. It's a constant. Then you have the post-traumatic shock disorder that is developed from any catastrophic event. I have been through all of that. It is difficult because it's an open wound that 6 years after 9/11, it has not been closed. Families, victims, survivors, and those affected by the event, I'm still suffering. We're still suffering. It's like it was yesterday. I got attacked because I said, I am 9/11, because everybody that was there is 9/11. But we will leave it every single day. We never stop to do that.
I've had the similar situation with the Survivor's Guild. And like you, I don't feel like I can ever get closure until...
You find the truth or the truth is told?
Until the truth is told. Do you have a position, do you have a degree to which you accept that? Or is it full disclosure or...
Do I have a degree of the truth? There's no degree for the truth. The truth is the truth. It should be told no matter what. I believe that we have half of the truth and it was manipulated. So it's unacceptable. It is inconsistent with what we wanted from the very beginning. You're not going to give me what you expect us for us to digest. You have to give me the whole truth, no matter how hard it is, how difficult it is for us to digest, how difficult it is for the family to handle. You have to give us exactly what happened. And we just want the complete truth, not a half-cooked story of what happened because they want to appease the families. No, we want the whole thing.
Just one last question. Tomorrow's the 4th of July. People suggested their own government was involved in mass murder. Would be seen as unpatriotic, but do you believe that this quest for the truth is probably the most patriotic things Americans can do?
Tomorrow is the 4th of July, and we have been questioned for the work that we are doing because we questioned the government official story. It is patriotic to defend your nation against foreign and domestic enemies. That's a patriotic way to do it. We have a canceled constitution in the United States. We are living by a fallacy. We have a quasi-dictatorship right now. It is the patriotic way to stand up and question those in power to do the right thing. I think that tomorrow, the 4th of July, represent not only my feelings, because I am a patriotic loving citizen of the United States. I was born with my citizenship. But I will fight for that liberty and for that truth no matter what. My constitution should be restored.